So these are the 4 steps that will help us complete the task of dorm room Debbie going from being hungry to being satisfied with pizza. It's important that we start with these high-level steps before we start thinking about any of the details. As part of the wireframing process, we need to remind ourselves of our persona and their use cases. So our use cases are, she's up late and she wants pizza right away. Or, it's been a long week and she wants to try something new and fun.
Now, this is a mobile app, so regardless of who the user is, we cannot violate the following mobile user constraints, such as limited data and battery life, handedness, divided attention, and so on.
And the next step is our feature list. The feature list is driven by dorm room Debbie's attributes and her use cases. Let's not focus too much on how we're going to put these features in our application just yet, but let's just look at them in a list.
Look below in the instructor notes and you'll find a link to this Prezi. Open it up in your web browser and follow along for the rest of the lesson.
And now we're going to dig a little bit deeper into the flow of our app. So we showed you the 4 high-level steps that we need to go through to complete the task of Debbie going from hungry to being satisfied. Now let's jump into the flow for each of these steps.
So here's step 1. This is the screen that a user sees when they first enter the application. And honestly, there's only one of 3 things they can do. They can build a brand new pizza if they've never used the application before, or they can reorder a previous pizza if they've used this app before. And if they have a pizza that's already been ordered, they can check its order status. So in order to begin, we will pick the first option, which is they're going to build a new pizza. Step 2 is where the user is going to configure their pizza and make sure that it's exactly what they want by choosing the size, the crust, the toppings, side orders, and so on. Now, if they don't want to actually build the pizza, they can view the daily specials and pick one of those.
And the third step is where they check out and pay. If the user hasn't already signed in, they'll do so here. If they've already saved their payment and delivery information, they can easily just skip through those steps or they can enter it in. And then they place their order. So if you've used this application before, step 3 will be really fast. All you have to do is click place your order. Once Debbie's placed her order, she'll see the order status. And if she has a question about her order, she can contact the driver.
So let's say that Debbie has placed an order for a pizza already. That was a couple of days ago. She liked the pizza, she likes the app. She came back in and now she wants to reorder the same thing again. This is where she would select option 2, which is reorder a previous pizza. This flow is actually really, really simple. She's probably signed in already. If she hasn't, then she will be asked to sign in. This might seem a little bit strange, but consider the possibility that Debbie has more than one phone or more than one Android device. She could have a tablet, multiple phones, and so on. Anyway, so if she's signed in, then she'll be able to see all the order history for previous orders and then select one and place an order for it.
Now we're back to step 3, which is check out and pay. Because she's already signed in, all she'll have to press is place order. And step 4 will be the same.